Hello student, I am Arnav Das. Today we discuss about another kind of representation of convolution code. Last day we talked about the state diagram. Today we discuss another one representation for convolution code, and there the trees diagram and the trellis diagram. Last day, by using the state diagram, how the convolution code will be represented, you are also able to identify. And for this, there the state table initially you have to know, and by this state table you have to form the state diagram. In this case, we are considering the 2-1-2 convolution code, or convolution code is generated for this diagram. For the state table here, 2-1-2 convolution code is defined. For the first two is due to the n, that is define the how many number of output line is there, and second this one is represent for how many number of input line is there, that is k, and last this two is defined for how many number of memory unit is there, that is small m. So by this the state table, if you know from this state table, you can able to draw the state diagram, and from the state diagram you can also identify what will be the code word or convolution code for any kind of message. If we consider the message is u is equal to, let the message is u is equal to 101. So what will be the code word for this case? Initially, this state diagram is starting from the 000, that is memory unit is as a present state, its value is 0 on there. Okay, now you are applying the input 1. So due to the input of 1, the output will become, this is the input line of 1, and that time the output will be coming there 11. So you have to put there 11, and then the newly come the next state is value is the 10, and for this 10 there the again the another one input you have to apply, and this is the 0. So for the 0 input, the output will be as value of 10. This is the output 10 you put, and newly come next state value is the 01. From this 01 again you have to apply the input 1. So for the input 1, that time the output will become as a value of 00. So this is the code for the convolution code form, and that is the 111000 for the message bit of 101. So this is the way by which, if you know the state diagram, what will be the convolution code can also able to determine. Now today we discuss about the another kind of diagram, for the trees diagram. For the trees diagram, there simple thing you have to remember, that is that the downward branch in each level of the tree corresponds to the output obtaining for the input 0, and that upward indicate for the input 1. Okay, so this simple thing you have to remember when you're forming the trees diagram. That is, again I just repeat that, when you apply the input 0, because for the 2-1-2, if you consider in here, the single one will be the input, and for the single input will be, can be 0, can be 1. So if you apply the input 0, that time branch will be flow to the downward direction, and when you apply a single input as a value of 1, that time the branch will be follow the upward direction. Okay, state table is the same one which is already told the previous one case. You have to check this one. Okay, what happened on there? So here initially, if we consider the state or present state value is 0 on there, this is the value is 0 on there, and if you apply the value of 0, if you apply the input value of 0, that time the next state value will become as a S0. This is better for the, you have to write down the state name as S0, S1, S2 as such. So when the present state value is the S0, that time due to the addition of 0 input, it will become as a S0 for the next state, and that time the output is 0 0. Again, I just repeat that for the S0, for the S0, their input value for the 0, the next state value will be the 0, and the output will become as a 0 0. And if for the same S0 present state position value, if the input is the 1, that time the next state value will become S2 and the output will be 1 1. Check that this one is coming on here or not. Look that in here, if you apply the input as a 0, that time it will be go to the downward direction. This is due to the reason for the input you are applying 0, and for the input 0, that time state value is coming here is 0, and below of this 0 0 is defined the output value. Again, I just repeat that this below value for this one will be defined the output value. And if you apply the input 1, that time it will be the upward direction, and that time the newly come state value will become as a S3. This is the next state, and that time the output will be 1 1. So you have to write down 1 1 on there. Now if you check in here for the state of S2, now here for the state of the S2, this is the level on here. So for the S2, there the if you apply the input 1, that time you have to go to the upward direction. And what will be this one case? Look that for the S2 input, you are applying value of 1 as input. Okay, for the S2 input, check that this one case. For the S2 as a present state value, this is the S2 is the present state value now. And due to the reason of the input as a 1, this is the input as a 1, the newly come, the next state value is the S3. So this is the upward direction. Why this is upward direction? Because you are applying 1. So this is the upward direction. That time value is the S3. That is the output on that case is the 0 1. So you have to write down below of this S3 is the 0 1. And when you are applying the input is as a value of 0, if you apply the input as a value of 0 for the S2 as a present state, that time the next state value will become as a S1. So this is the S1 is the next state value, and that time the output is coming as a 1 0. So this is the output is represented as a value of 1 0, and that is written as a below of the S1. Okay, so this is the way by which you have to form, or you can form the state diagram on the tree diagram for the 2 1 2 as a convolution code. Take another one step so it will be easy for understand also. Let we consider this one position. Let we are considering this one position S3. This is now the present state. So this is now the present state. If you apply the input 0, that time what happened? Newly come or next state value will be the S1. So for the input 0, it will be go to the downward direction. This will be the go to the downward direction. So this is the S1, and that time the output is the 0 1. So you have to write down 0 1 at the below of this. Same way for this S3, for this S3 as a present state value, for this S3 as a present state value, if you apply the input 1, that time newly or next state value will become as a S3. So due to the reason of this is input is 1, so you have to go to the upward direction, and that time the S3 is the newly come or next state value, and that time the output is 1 0. So you have to put here as a 1 0 for the output 1. So by this way you can complete the total diagram, and there how many number of level you have to create, how many number of level you have to create, it will be dependent how many number of input you are providing on there. As I say, in this case total number of level is create total 5. So this is starting from the if you consider this one, this is starting from the 0 from the first toward the up to the 5. So let we consider the input. Let this is the input is the u is equal to 101. So what will be the convolution code as output? Initially state is the S0. So for the S0, if you apply the 1 as input, so you have to go to the upward direction. So that time the output is 1 1. So you have to put the value of 1 1, then comma, then from this new state position, that is the s2 position is come on there, and from this s2 you have to go to the 0, so you have to go to the downward direction. So this is the s1 is the newly come state, and that the output is 1 0, so you have to put the 1 0 as the output, and from this s1 again you have to apply the 1 as the input, so you have to go to the upward direction. That time newly come state is the s2 and the output is 0 0, so this is 0 0. So look, that the same thing is repeated on there. Today before doing or before starting of this class, we also see that if you apply for the state diagram as input 101, that time also this will become as a convolution code, that is the 111000. So any kind of diagram you can be follow on there to get the ultimate encoded convolution code. This is not matter that what kind of diagram you are choosing for identifying the encoded convolution code. If you do the process as a correct format, then obviously your answer will be the same for any kind of this diagram you are choosing on there. But there's some little bit drawback on there. Why? Because if the number of input line is or input message is so many, that is the if in this case it is not as a 3, 4, 5 number of bit for the input message, and that time this is diagram you have to do as a tedious process, and after that you can easily got the value for the convolution code. But that is not ultimate matter, because this step is repeated for each and every cases on there. Look that how it is repeated on there. If you consider this one as a form 00, this one portion, so s0, and then this is coming as a s2, then this is 00 in such a way. This one also come on there for another kind of position also. Look that this one position where this is repeated. So after that, this is also look that. So if you check in proper way, then a little bit calculation can be made on that. But initially, and this is little bit problematic for the number of bit for the message bit is higher one. So though as I told, trees diagram, state diagram, or trellis diagram, any one process you can be used on there for identifying the code word for the completion code. So for today, this is the enough one, and next day we talk about the trellis code. Please stay with us and continue with this one topic. Have a good day.